Hey there, HBI Guys Model Workshop here, back with another review. This time it's going to be of Academy's M2 Bradley U.S. Army Infantry Fighting Vehicle. Now, this is in the most common armored scale of 1/35th, and that's so that it lines up with all your other armored vehicles. I was able to pick this kit up within the last 6 months for $23.99. That is a steal for a highly detailed military model kit. Anyone who models armor or other military kits doesn't even shy away from starting at $60 for a kit, $50, and going up from there. When I saw this one was available, I'm not a huge military builder, but I do really like the vehicles, and especially tracked vehicles because of my history. And so I grabbed this one right away and wanted to take a look at everything in the box. And really, I was not disappointed. To me, this looks almost like it's a copy of a Tamiya kit, or like Tamiya rented out the molds to Academy. I have nothing to back that up with except just looking at the sprues. The copyright date on the instruction manual in the box, even though I bought the kit brand new from an online hobby shop less than 6 months ago, is like 1995. So this kit has been out for quite a long time. These companies do rent out their molds to each other, so it could be a Tamiya kit relabeled by Academy when Tamiya made their Bradley kit more advanced. I'm not really sure. I'm sure the experts will let me know soon enough in the comment section, and we can clear all of that up. But for everything you're going to see, it sure looks a lot like a older Tamiya mold that Academy is repopping out, because it's just a beautiful kit. Inside, we'll actually put that up there. Inside the box, of course, is the big manual, and down on the bottom is where I saw the copyright for 1995. I think the Bradley, the M2 Bradley, is such a cool-looking vehicle, and that's why I wanted to have it. Now, it's a straightforward build. There are a buttload of parts in this kit, so it's going to take you a while. It is a tracked vehicle. You've got to build your road wheels. You got, you know, your idlers are springs, your struts are built into the chassis, and we'll get to that for a moment. But you still have to build all your road wheels, and they tell you how to assemble them. You're going to have hatches. You're going to have grab irons. You're going to have rear doors. You're going to have mantlets to put together. You're going to have the armor on the upper turret to put together. The tracks, you're going to have to put grills on over the engines. It is a really nice looking, very detailed kit. And the manual goes through step by step with great illustrations. No writing, but just great illustrations to let you know exactly what part you're going to use, exactly where it's going to go. And they also do color callouts. Now, when you build something like this, it's extremely easy to just go online, look up M2 Bradley, and paint it as you see it online. There is not much in the way of decals. Military vehicles aren't covered with a lot of, you know, cool stickers and paintings. There's only a very, very small decal in the kit, and that's it right there. So when you need to put on your vehicle identifiers right here and right here, you're either going to have to make them out of black decal paper, or, really easy, go on eBay or any website that sells military kits and 1/35th scale vehicle identifiers, military markings. The decal kits are out there and they're not expensive whatsoever. So I think that's a big oversight by Academy, but they didn't put those at all in there. This is all you're going to get for decals, which is just enough to letter one vehicle. And then you will have to do the rest yourself if you want to make it for an exact division or battalion. Then you'll have to do that all on your own with this kit, which is a pretty common thing with military kits. Let's get to what else is in the box. These cool tracks. I like one-piece tracks. A lot of people hate them. I like them because they're super easy to weather in detail. The multi-piece tracks, especially the hard styrene ones that come, they call them length and link. I hate those tracks. I really, really do. A lot of people like them. They work with them real easy. It's styrene when they're length and link, so they accept paint easy. These vinyl tracks will accept acrylic paints easy. They won't take enamel paint, so don't even try. But if you coat them first with acrylics, you can weather and do some painting with enamels, and then they'll stick. But if you try to do everything with enamels, they're never going to dry on this vinyl. It's just a property of the paint. So the tracks look great. They're really flexible. They're going to be easy to work with. You can see, I mean, there's once you warm them up, you'll get any little bit of memory that they had out of them. They're already starting to lay flat when I took them out of the box. If you just run them over with a hair dryer a couple times or my heat gun, they'll lay completely flat. You can see how to weather tracks like this on a modern fighting vehicle by looking at my build of the Revell M1 Abrams main battle tank. These are nicely detailed. They're going to look great once painted and assembled. Won't be hard at all. And the nice part is that being the one piece length and length, the one piece vinyl, they're just going to push together like so, glue together, and then you're all set. You just heat them up and you're all ready to go. Those are going to mount on the vehicle real simply. They're real easy to work with. They speed up the entire process. Now, there is a good amount of plastic trees, so we'll just start going through them as I reach over and grab them from different sides. This is the first tree. Now, I'm not extremely familiar with the M2 Bradley personally, so I'm not going to know all the part names on them, but we're going to try to identify, you know, a reasonable amount that I can. This, of course, looks like the hatch in the back. You got a tow cable. And we've got some hatches, vents, vent covers, some grab irons. We'll just go through this slowly and let you all look at that. We've got a nice little axe there. That's on the lower right. Got the gun mantlet right there. Looks like we've got the barrel. We've got some tanker tools. We got some bars. We got a tanker's tool. We've got a sledgehammer, a spade, a shovel. All the equipment you need to unstuck your tracked vehicle or get a track back on, wedge it back on, get a pin back in. Got to take all that with you. They're not going to stop the war, so you can get off and get everything fixed. So that's the first, and everything, except for the tracks, is molded in tan plastic. We've got some side skirts here, very nice looking. Very nice detail on those. We've got the rear hatch assembly, be your armored butt end of the M2. And we've got some more hatches for the TC and gunners. We've actually got the TC right there, and he is a nicely molded figure. And we got the arms right there. We've got what looks like the main gun barrel. Want a little bit of venting on the tip. Nice molding in there. And we've got the assembly for the rear door, the rear hatch. Flip it over again. We've got your engine grills, your intakes, and on those intakes, we'll reach over quick, they give you this screen to cut, to put over there, because those would have screens over them, of course, so that they don't suck in too much dirt, people's feet, somebody tosses a grenade down in there. As we work our way through, we've got the other side skirt. Looks a little bit different than the other side, as you can see. They're two different ones. So that's the first two trees, and we got a good amount to go. This smaller tree here is of your turret. Nice looking molding. Those are your periscopes so that they can look out. You'll have to paint those or find the appropriate color decal to make those simulate like they have glass in them. There is no clear parts in here. So anything you want to do, you're going to have to make on your own, which is, once again, a common thing, especially on a budget-priced kit. So if you want to put any glass, simulate any prisms, that you're going to have to do on your own, and there are a gajillion tips online to do so. This little part here, not really that important. This just holds your road wheels on. Shove them in. That makes your hubs. You're all set to go. That's a little vinyl part. You get two trees like this that I'm putting out right now. These are going to be your road wheels and other small parts. You get two of the same tree. You can see your drive wheel, your return wheel, and your idlers, your road wheels. Nice detail on there. Real nice. Real nice. Look at those. Very sharp. Beautiful kit. Your M16s. sharp stuff. So you get two of those. You get two of those trees. The last big parts tree is right there. And of course, this looks like part of the interior of the deck. We'll get you in close. A lot of small parts on this tree as well. See some pack equipment. And then here we got these sections for the large top. For the turret. At least what I'm looking at, these probably should go inside, and that's where the actual operator of the turret would be standing or sitting, depending on how it's configured. We got some other interior parts. Lots of ammo boxes. You could try to get in there. See the detail on those. So a lot of detail parts, especially when you want to make it look nice. You want to put your time into it, painting, weathering, and detailing. Now here we have the main hull, which is done up quite well. You can see different things on the interior, and then all your locator areas here. And these holes are down here. It might have been a motorized kit at one point, but there's no use for those holes anymore. You can just cover them up or leave them. If someone turns over your model to see a hole in the bottom, slap them in the head, tell them HBI guy said so. Okay, everything's marked out nicely for you. You have to locate parts. And then there's your torsion bars, all built on, which is nice. I like that. Some people want to place them individually. The only problem is that with these already pre-assembled like this, if you want to put it in a diorama, you're going to have to cut them off and relocate them carefully so that you can actually position the track so that they're not completely flat. But most of mine are just sitting on a shelf, so they should be completely flat anyways. And then the final plastic part, the hull, the main upper hull. And you can see the great molding on that. Tons of holes for locating all your stowage and grab handles, accessories, equipment. Look at all those holes. Look at them all. Just look at them. You can see nice 3D molding on there. I don't know how they do all that, but they do a great job of it. Nice grill. Right down to the crossbars. Small hatches, fuel. That molding is just excellent, that kind of 3D. Of course it is 3D, but I'm saying the way they were able to mold it with the sharp edges like that. So there you go, folks. That is Academy's M2 Bradley. Definitely worth the price. I would recommend it if you like building military kits, or if you just like unique kits in general. This is a must-have. Thanks for watching HBI Guys Model Workshop. Subscribe, leave comments below, let me know what you think. Thanks for watching.